Before you can create a grade ladder, you must create your grades. Open the Workforce Structures work area. Confirm your start date and grade set, then enter a name and code. Enter the grade steps. This example has 3, but you can add as many as needed. Your ceiling step will be defaulted as you go and is often the highest step in the grade. You can use the Set as Ceiling Step button to change it. Then create your grade ladder, which puts your grades into sequence. You have 3 options to create your grade ladder. If you're using grade step progression, you need to create a progression grade ladder. In this example, we'll create a progression grade ladder where the grades have steps. The process for creating a progression grade ladder without steps is similar. If you don't want to create a progression grade ladder, you can use the 3rd option. Set the start date that this new grade ladder will be effective and give it an intuitive name. The grade type defaults based on the type of grade ladder you selected. Select the grade set, which determines the grades you'll have available to add to this grade ladder. Select the legislative data group, which determines which types of workers can have this ladder associated with their assignment. The rest of the attributes determine how the run grade step progression process calculates the values for the proposed grade and step. You also have the option to add this new ladder to a group, and when the process is run, it will run for the entire group. When you're running grade step progression, you have the option to update the worker's salary as well as their assignment. If you want to take the rate from your grade ladder to update the worker's salary, choose this option. The remaining attributes determine how the run grade step progression process calculates the proposed salary. The Rate Synchronization section is used for the second batch process, Synchronize Grade Step Rates. These attributes determine how the process calculates the proposed salary. Next, add the rate. Give it an intuitive name that's unique across all the rates. Choose the same LDG that you selected previously. Grade step progression requires that the rate type is salary. Then select the appropriate frequency and confirm the annualization factor and currency. After you save your rate selections, the application automatically marks this as the progression rate. Then add grades. This list will only show grades that have steps because of the type of grade ladder you selected. Search for and click the first grade you want to add. You can add as many grades as you need to. By default, additional grades are placed at the end, but you can change the placement as needed. After you've added all your grades, you can enter your step rate values. Enter the rates for each of the steps. After you're done, you can apply these changes and move to the next set of rates, or cycle through the rates using the next and previous arrows. After you've entered all your rates, click Apply and Close. If you have a long list of grades, you can use the search field and filters to find a grade you've already added. After you've entered all your rate values, click Submit. Thanks for watching.